Hi everyone, it's Carolina from Gotta Love Polish. Welcome back to my channel. Welcome if you're new. So in today's video, I want to share with you all my seasonal polish rack. This is another collaboration with Amanda from the Nail Polish Hound and the other fantastic nail polish lovers that are going to be listed down below. Please don't forget to check out their videos, give them a like and subscribe if you enjoy their content as well as mine. This is going to be part two of this video. This is the entirety of my nail polish rack. It's a five-tier rolling nail polish shelf that I have jam-packed. Actually, no, I lied. It's not exactly jam-packed, but it is pretty full of nail polishes that I want to try to wear this season. I understand this is just really honestly at this point, I just like looking at the pretty colors. I don't have shelves in my room where I can showcase my nail polish obsession and look at the colors and think, oh, that's so pretty, I can't wait to wear that eventually. So my seasonal polish rack is the way that I bring out the new polishes that are in my collection that I really try to wear. I have also been re-wearing as pedicure polishes, older polishes that I just don't have a chance to put on my hands anymore. So, with that being said, let's get started because this is a long video. We're gonna start off with the mainstream polishes. The mainstream bottles are not in color coordination like Roy G. Biv format because I had pulled those out before I decided to try to do the shelving in the Roy G. Biv format. And so, yeah, they're just not in the color coordination that the rest of the indies are. So we're just gonna start off with OPI. And this one here is called Susie Needs a Locksmith. Let me tell you, this is kind of a, if you haven't seen my other video, this is a sneak peek to what I am loving this season right now. A lot of oranges, lots of burnt oranges. Before I forget, I totally meant to say what I'm wearing on my nails right now. I put two coats of this Wildflower Lacquer in Sunbeams, and then I decided to do some nail art on my nails with Sunbeam as the base, which is these orange color of polishes there on the lead. The three other colors that you see in the nail art is this Ethereal Lacquer in Aries. This is KB Shimmer in That's Nude to Me. And this is KB Shimmer in, oh my ganache. The next OPI color is Have Your Panettone and Eat It Too. I feel like I'm saying that wrong. OPI in Pepe's Purple Passion. A classic OPI that I have yet to wear. This one here is Linkin Park After Dark. We have one straggling Julie G polish, nail polish, and this one is called Obsessed. We have an OPI, and this one is called Darkest Shadow. Wet n Wild Mega Last Color, and this one is called Wet Cement. Here we have an H&M, and this one is called Equestrian. And I think this is about 2 years old, and I have yet to wear it. What is wrong? Next, we have an Essie, and this one is called Infinity Cool. I think I purchased this recently because of Diana from Some Call Me Coco. Here we have Essie in Leggy Legend. I think I wore this one, but I could have just worn it as an accent. Another Essie, and this one is called Rust Worthy. And just in case you thought that they were similar, this is Leggy Legend and Rust Worthy, and they are not similar at all. I mean, they're similar, but not the same. And here we have Lace Me Up. I've had this for a while, and I have yet to wear it. Essie in Precious Cargogo. Again, another one that I bought when it came out and I have yet to wear it. Sorry, Essie Expressy. And this one is called Don't Hate Cure. We have Essie in Set the Tiki Bar High. This is a summer color, but I feel like it's a good purple for Halloween. We have China Glaze in Sample Sizing Me Up. Here we have a Sinful Color in a matte, and this is Dark Romance. Sinful Color in Empire Green. Sinful Color in Gothic Ink. Sinful Color, this one is Navy I Do. Sinful Color in Electric Sage. We have a Sinful Color in Jam Out. China Glaze in Dress Me Up, Sinful Color in Shine Annie. We have Zoya in Scout. We have a Color Club in Get Lost. OPI in Stay Off the Lawn. China Glaze in Don't Let the Dead Bite. China Glaze in Autumn's Up. OPI in Let Your Love Shine. China Glaze in Bluya. China Glaze in Trendsetter. China Glaze in Combat Blutes. And this is going to start off the Roji Biv format of this video, starting off with the reddish berry wine colors that I seem to be attracted to this fall season. This is Enchanted Polish in Black and Cherry Opal. Sorry, Black Cherry Opal. Next we have Colores de Carol in Slappy's Tie. We have Blush Lacquer in Tartan Rose. I did receive this for PR. This is Bee's Knees Lacquer, Blood is All, and I did purchase this. Next we have the Crimson Hag, and I do believe I got this in PR, but I could have purchased this. Night Out Lacquer in And Now I'm a Wizard. The base may not be red, but I feel like this leans red to me. Night Owl Lacquer in Blood of a Wendigo. We have Enchanted Polish in Coven. Dreamland Lacquer in All Wine All the Time. Night Owl Lacquer in It Takes Guts to Be Yourself. Bluebird Lacquer in The Rum Shaker. And this one is leaning a little brown on camera to me. I think we've moved on to the orange polishes, and this is Blush Lacquer in Persimmon Bay. At first I thought it was almost a dead-on dupe for Sunbeams, because Sunbeams has this really pretty pink shift that is not as noticeable in the bottle, but is really noticeable on the nails. But this is definitely warmer and pinkier than Sunbeams is. Next we have Wildflower Lacquer in Tweet Hearts. I've actually used this polish for reverse stamping before, and it is glorious. Next we have polish in Ichabod, and my mom's actually worn this, but I haven't yet. Next we have Cuticula in Belle Night. Beautiful Night. This is Night Owl Lacquer in Mistress of Evil, and it definitely is more of a red orange. Oh my goodness, it looks so pretty. Flower Lacquer in Time to Wind Down. Next we have Lemming Lacquer in Jack of the Lantern. We have Different Dimensions in And All I Loved Alone. Olive Ave Polish in Pumpkin. How could I not wear this one? Blush Lacquer in Charming Chestnut. Now this one is like a orangey brown. I really like this color. Yeah, MJ Lacquer in You Already Have a Brown. I know it's supposed to be brown, but honestly, I feel like it leans orange to my eyes. We have Wildflower Lacquer in Heaven Scent. Tonic in Greatest Pumpkin. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Conjuration. Wildflower Lacquer in Witcher's Retire. Night Owl Lacquer in Gorgeous. I don't know why that made me laugh. We're starting to hit the yellows, and this is sort of a limey, chartreusey kind of yellow. This one is Hustle from Sir Colors. I don't know if I mentioned that. This one is Luminous Lacquer in Honey Bee. Colores de Carol in The Cuckoo Clock of Doom. Polish M in Maïs. Sir Colors in Urbanized. can't believe I've never worn this yet. And we have Bee Sneeze Lacquer. Oh, this is starting the third tier. This is Bee Sneeze Lacquer, and I Love Do the same. This is kind of more green, yellow. I don't know, it's hard to tell sometimes. This one's definitely a yellow. This is Magic School Bus. Again, this is, I don't know, not very good Roy G. Biv. This is KL Polish and Peanut Butter, which is more, I don't know, brown? And we have KL Polish in Caramelo. This is for sure the greens. This is Cirque Colors in Beatnik. I have worn this in a Skittle Mani, but not on its own. Bee Sneeze Lacquer in Faded Away. Different Dimensions in Extraterrestrial. Wildflower Lacquer in I Once Played a Nurse on MASH. We have 90 Lacquer in Decay. Polished for Days in Shadow on the Moon. Tonic Polish in Martini. Enchanted Polish in Garden of Magic. Supernatural Lacquer in The Gill Man. And yes, I have two really close together olive green hollows. I don't care. I like them. Next we have Alchemy Lacquers in Bad Candy. Zombie Claw in Sage. Blush Lacquers in Moss Covered Cottage. Kathleen and Co. in Predator. Night Owl Lacquer in The Right Way and Then Yours. Blush Lacquers in Pulsatronic Brain. I think I received this in PR. ILMP in Legacy. Vanessa Molina in Spooky. Painted Polish in Moss Meditation. Nailed It Lacquers in Yellow Eyes. Nailed It Lacquer in Ashes and Embers. Supernatural Lacquer in All of a Sudden. Polish in Starborn. Ethereal Lacquer in Snake Eyes. Paradox Polish in Azazel. Oh god, I feel like I'm saying that wrong. And I do believe that this one is a magnetic. Yep, it's a magnetic. Oh god, that's beautiful. Enchanted Polish in Groovy Ghoul. I feel like I worn this. I want to say I wore this one. Wildflower Lacquer in Sunset Bringer. Polish in Hellbore. Tonic Polish in Fatigued. Then we have Bee Sneeze Lacquer in Every Star in the Sky Shines for You. And now we start off on the third tier, and this one is starting with the blue, which are mostly teal almost. This is Emily DeMolly in Elevate You. Next we have Wildflower Lacquer in Indifferent to the Past. Bee Sneeze Lacquer in Lady of Storms. Bee Sneeze Lacquer in Moreau. Wildflower Lacquer in Mr. Wildflower. Bee Sneeze Lacquer in There's My Grumpy Shadow Princess. Polish in Rusalak. I can't say that name right there. Blush Lacquers in Off the Clock. KB Shimmer in Eyes on the Pies. Polished for Days, When I Grow Up. Lucky 13 Lacquer, The Suspense is Terrible. Glisten and Glow, Amethyst Skies. Night Owl Lacquer, The Buried Moon. Blush Lacquer, Evening Rose. Paradox Polish, Oh Bollocks. And this is a magnetic as well. We have a Lemming Lacquer, and this is in Amortentia. This one was gifted to me, so I'm its second owner. Bee's Knees Lacquer, Kumihio. I'm saying that all wrong, I'm sorry. Polished for Days in Ikigai. Wildflower Lacquer, Tonight We Fly. Painted Polish in Dewdrop Dreams. Flower Lacquer in Faith's a Simple Medicine for Desperate Souls. Kathleen & Co. Ghost Manor. Rogue Lacquer in Suck It To Me Baby. Painted Polish in Sucker For A Slayer. Night Owl Lacquer, The Archer. Ethereal Lacquer, Ghost Face. Wildflower Lacquer, You're My Happy Ending. Polish in Grindelwald. Kathleen and Company in Den of Iniquity. Wildflower Lacquer, Como La Flor. Wildflower Lacquer, Captive Heart. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Donna and Angie. Wildflower Lacquer in Potion. Okay, this next tier, which is the last tier on my rack, is kind of a hodgepodge of polishes that had nowhere to go. I found them after I had already set up the tiers and I didn't want to mess with anything. So we have Polish in Persephone, Ethereal in Dark Intentions, Polish for Days, Are You Listening? Bee's Knees Lacquer, Dark Bidding. Wildflower Lacquer, Sealed With a Kiss. KB Shimmer, Hanging With My Grill Friends. Ethereal Lacquer in Infernal. Rogue Lacquer, Dumpster Fire. Wildflower Lacquer, Bish Better Have My Money. Ethereal in Relax, It's Only Magic. KB Shimmer in Obsidian. Wildflower Lacquer, Black Magic, and this one is a magnetic. I don't see much of a magnetic effect, but it's still really pretty polished. Wildflower in Eternal Autumn. Wildflower Lacquer in You're Fudging the Best. You're the Fudging Best. Oh my goodness. Great Lakes Lacquer in Olive Succulents. Rogue Lacquer, Big Ben. Bee's Knees Lacquer in Dead Doesn't Mean Gone. Bee's Knees Lacquer, Make No Bargains or Ties with the Silver Eyes. Blush Lacquer in Chocolate Rose. This is so pretty. Blush Lacquer in Benevolent Bay. This is suffering from severe ugly bottle syndrome. Paint and Polish in Badass Beauty. Sateen Polish in The Wisdom of the Leaves. This is a magnetic topper. Ooh. Let me see. There we go. Tonic Polish in Infrared. Fancy Gloss in The Child. Bee's Knees Lacquer on Nighttime Smoke. Bee's Knees Lacquer, Not Everybody Does. Boo Bird Lacquer, Presto Change-O, and this is a magnetic as well. Bee's Knees Lacquer, Tootie Stinky Foot, Stink Foot. Wax Polish in My Neighbor Totoro. Night Owl Lacquer, Dark Fantasy. Wildflower Lacquer, Invincible. Polish in Boo Quixote. All right, so that is it. Those are all the polishes. Well, they're not all the polishes, but they're all the polishes that are on my rack for the autumnal season. Thank you everyone so much for checking out my video today. Don't forget to check out all of the other lovely nail polish people who are going to be putting their list or their rack up for display, or maybe just curating their collection to a couple of colors that they want to wear this season. Regardless, it's always fun to see what other people are gravitating towards. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. Thanks again to everybody who is working on this collaboration and Amanda for putting everything together for us. And I hope you enjoyed this video, everyone. I'll see you in my next one. Bye.